We've revised grammar, subject and predicate, and sentence. Okay, so today we will do the revision for courage. All right, so let me share the screen with you. I want all of you to read along with me, okay, so that you guys can remember whatever you have studied for courage. Okay. Okay, what is the meaning of conviction? Conviction is a firm belief. Okay, conviction, firm belief. Okay, conviction, firm belief. Integrity, honesty. Integrity, honesty. Please, requests. Please. Requests, resound, echo. Okay, resound, echo. Again, conviction, firm belief, integrity, honesty, please, requests, resound, echo. Okay, memory lines. Courage is the strength to stand up when it's easier to fall down and lose hold. It's the conviction to explore new horizons when it's easier to believe what we've been told. Again, courage is a strength to stand up. Read with me louder. Okay, courage is a strength to stand up when it's easier to fall down and lose hold. It is a conviction to explore new horizons when it's easier to believe what we've been told. Courage is the desire to maintain our integrity when it's easier to look the other way. It is feeling happy and alive and moving forward when it's easier to feel sorry for ourselves and stay. Once again, courage is the desire to maintain our integrity when it's easier to look the other way. It is feeling happy and alive and moving forward when it's easier to feel sorry for ourselves and stay. Okay, please make sure you learn the memory lines if you're not thorough with it. Okay, moving on. When is courage called strength? Courage is called strength when you can stand up when it may be easier to fall down. Okay, courage is called strength when you can stand up and it may be easier to fall down. What does having conviction make you do? Convictions make you explore new horizons, though it may be easier to believe what you have been told. Okay, convictions make you explore new horizons, though it may be easier to believe what you have been told. Okay, when are we motivated to be honest? What do we not do then? We are motivated to be honest when we are courageous. Okay, we are motivated to be honest when we are courageous. We do not look the other way then. Okay, we do not look the other way then. We are motivated to be honest when we are courageous. We do not look the other way then. Okay, please recollect the answers as we are reading, because this all we have done thorough revision. So now we are doing another revision. So it must be easier for you to recall the answers that we've already read. Okay. How does courage help us to shape our world? Courage gives us the will and the determination to shape our world. Okay, how does courage help us to shape our world? Courage gives us the will and determination to shape our world. It gives us the will and determination to shape our world. When do we stop criticizing others around us? We stop criticizing others around us when we realize that we ourselves are not perfect. Okay? When do we stop criticizing others around us? When we realize that we ourselves are not perfect. Okay, courage can place us at the top of the mountain. What does the poet mean by this? The poet means that courage can make you achieve great heights. Okay, the poet means that courage can make you achieve great heights. Courage can make you achieve great heights. Okay, it is feeling happy and alive and moving forward when it's easier to feel sorry for ourselves and stay. So what does it refer to here? It refers to courage. It here refers to courage. Okay, it here refers to courage. What does the poet mean by moving forward? By moving forward, the poet means going ahead in spite of any failures or setbacks we may have faced. Okay, what does the poet mean by moving forward? By moving forward, the poet means going ahead in spite of any failures or setbacks we may have faced. Okay, what happens when you feel sorry for yourself? What emotion does one experience then? When you feel sorry for yourself, you are not able to motivate yourself to achieve great things. Okay, when you feel sorry for yourself, you are not able to motivate yourself to achieve great things. You stop progressing because you think you are incapable of achieving what you set out to do. Okay, you experience a feeling of despair and depression. Okay, when you feel sorry for yourself, you are not able to motivate yourself to achieve great things. You stop progressing because you think you are incapable of achieving what you set out to do. You experience a feeling of despair and depression. Okay. The foundation of courage is solid, the rock that doesn't roll. What does the poet say? Why does the poet say the foundation of courage is solid? The poet says the foundation of courage is solid because it doesn't make you waver or feel uncertain. Okay, the poet says the foundation of courage is solid because it doesn't make you waver or feel uncertain. It makes you determined to go ahead with what you want. Okay. It makes you determined to go ahead with what you want. Okay? The poet says the foundation of courage is solid because it doesn't make you waver or feel uncertain. It makes you determined to go ahead with what you want. Okay? To what is courage compared in these two lines? Courage is compared to a solid rock in these lines. Okay? Courage is compared to a solid rock in these lines. What do you understand by the last line? The last line means that being courageous makes us experience freedom of the mind, the body, and the soul. Okay, by being courageous, it makes us experience the freedom of the mind, body, and soul. We have the freedom of mind for what? To explore. The freedom of body for what? To attempt the impossible and achieve it. And freedom of the soul, finally, to have a sense of integrity and realization of our own imperfections. Okay, three things to have the experience of freedom of mind, body, and soul. First, freedom of mind is to explore. Freedom of body is to attempt for the impossible and achieve it. And freedom of the soul is to have a sense of integrity and realization of our own imperfections. Okay, so repeat this memory lines after me. Courage is the strength to stand up when it's easier to fall down and lose hold. It is the conviction to explore new horizons when it's easier to believe what we've been told. Courage is the desire to maintain our integrity when it's easier to look the other way. It is feeling happy and alive and moving forward when it's easier to feel sorry for ourselves and stay. Okay, So please read this courage thoroughly. Okay? Please read this courage thoroughly. One second. Okay? Okay, read thoroughly this courage, and we will move on to the People's President. Okay, so today you will read Courage and the People's President. Make sure you learn everything by heart, okay, so that it will be easier for you to write in the exam. Okay, let me share the screen again for the People's President. Okay, so the People's President okay, what is the meaning of insatiable? Insatiable. Unending acquisition, gathering, resonated, echoed, transcended, rose above, prototype. Model, biocompatible, harmless to the environment, shackle, chain, tactile, sensation of touch. Accolades, an award or privilege granted as a special honor of merit. Ignite light. Okay, insatiable, unending, acquisition, gathering, resonated, echoed, transcended, rose above, prototype, model, biocompatible, harmless to the environment, shackle, chain, tactile, sensation of touch, accolades, an award or privilege granted as a special honor of merit. Ignite is light. Okay. Now, antonyms. What is the opposite of confidence? Doubtful. Ignite. Extinguish. Extinguish. Note the spellings, please. Extinguish. Progressive. Regressive, optimism, pessimism, hope, despair, average, extraordinary. Or outstanding. Okay, confidence, doubtful, ignite, extinguish, progressive, regressive, optimism, pessimism, hope, despair, average, extraordinary or outstanding. Okay, what did Kalam, Dr. Kalam study at the Madras Institute of Technology? Dr. Kalam studied aerospace engineering at the Madras Institute of Technology. Okay, where did he join as a scientist? He joined the Aeronautical Development Establishment of the Defense Research and Development Organization as a scientist. Remember that it is DRDO, Defense Research Development Organization. So, where did he join as a scientist? He joined the Aeronautical Development Establishment of the Defense Research and Development Organization as a scientist. Okay, why was he known as a Missile Man of India? He was known as a Missile Man of India because of his work on the development of ballistic missile and launch vehicle technology. Okay, he was known as the Missile Man of India because of his work on the development of ballistic missile and launch vehicle technology. Because of his work on the development of ballistic missile and launch vehicle technology. Okay. Name any two books that he has written. He has written a number of books, of which Wings of Fire and Ignited Minds. Okay. Wings of Fire and Ignited Minds. Unleashing the Power Within India. Okay. Wings of Fire is one. Ignited Minds, that is Unleashing the Power of Power Within India, is another book. Okay. What was Dr. Kalam's life as a young boy? Dr. Kalam's father owned a ferry while his mother was a housewife. He was youngest of four brothers and sister and a sister. Okay, his father owned a ferry and his mother was a housewife. He was the youngest of four brothers and a sister. And his family lost much of its property and sold. And he sold newspapers to supplement his family's income as a young boy. Okay. He was an average student, but he evinced great interest in, that means he showed great interest, okay? He showed great interest in mathematics and was devoted to his studies, okay? So this you will write as first his father owned a ferry, his mother, housewife. He was the youngest of four brothers and a sister. His family lost much. Lost much of its property, but he sold newspapers as a young boy to supplement his family's income. And though he was an average student, he showed much interest in physics and mathematics. Okay, mathematics. All right. So why did he think children were important? Give reasons. He believed that children were important because he thought they were the hope for the future. And he wanted to help them to ignite their imagination and prepare them to develop them to work for a developed India for which a world map was already available. Okay, he wanted them to explore new horizons and work for what they wanted and not surrender to fate. Okay, Dr. Kalam believed that children were important because he thought they were the hope for the future, and he wanted to help them to ignite their imagination and prepare them to work for a developed India for which the world map was already available. He wanted them to explore new horizons and work for what they wanted and not surrender to fate. Okay, he wanted them to explore new horizons and work for what they wanted and not surrender to fate. What legacy did he leave behind on the president's estate? In the president's estate, Dr. Kalam was responsible for the digitalization of the library. One thing. Next thing is a tactile garden for the visually challenged. Okay. A health center, street lamps, pavements, new staff quarters, and above all, for opening the Rashtrapati Bhavan to everyone. Okay. So these are what the legacy that he left behind in the president's on the president's estate. So what was it? First one is digitalization of the library, tactile garden for the visually challenged, and also a health center, street lamps, pavements, new staff quarters, and above all for opening the Rashtrapati Bhavan to everyone. Okay. Do you think Dr. Kalam was a patriotic man? Why and why not? Dr. Kalam was a true patriot because He was a nation builder in the true sense of the term and transcended caste, religion, and language. Okay, he wanted to use technology to help the common man. So he, the disabled and also the disadvantaged sections of the society. He made a safe, biocompatible and long-lasting stent for heart patients from the alloys used in missile technology. Okay, he made a safe, biocompatible and long-lasting stent for heart patients from the alloys used in missile technology. Okay. What kind of a person was Dr. Abdul Kalam? Give examples from the passage. So Abdul Kalam was a simple person. He was a true patriot, a man who believed in the empowerment of students and used and made missiles, but talked of peace. Okay, he firmly believed that educational opportunities should be provided to all children as the only way to remove poverty. Okay, and he interacted with students across the country, sharing his experiences, teaching them to dream and imagine, learn, question, and work towards fulfilling their goals in life. He was a great learner who had a great curiosity to know and learn, which made him reach out for the impossible. He had a childlike enthusiasm despite all the accolades he received for his work. Okay, so you'll describe him. How is he a simple person? How is he a true patriot? Okay, what did he believe in? He believed in empowerment of students. He made missiles, but he talked of peace. He firmly believed that educational opportunities should be available for everybody. Okay, and so that we can remove poverty from the country. And also, he interacted with students across the country, sharing his experiences, teaching them to dream and imagine, learn, question, and work towards fulfilling their goals. He was a great learner. And who had a great curiosity to know and learn, which made him reach out for the impossible. He had a childlike enthusiasm despite all the accolades he received for his hard work. Why do you think Dr. Kalam placed so much faith in technology? Do you think he was right to do so? Give examples from the text and from your own experience. Okay. Dr. Kalam placed great faith in technology, and I think he was right to do so. How? He wanted to use technology to develop the country so that it could be at par with the other developed nations of the world. Okay, first point. He wanted to use technology to develop the country so that our country would never be lesser than any other country. Okay, he was involved in development of their ballistic missile and launch vehicle technology and was known as the Missile Man of India. Okay, he wanted to use technology to help common man and the disadvantaged and the disabled. Okay, he wanted to use technology to help common man and the disadvantaged and the disabled. So when he realized that a coronary stent cost over 60,000, he made a safe, biocompatible and long-lasting stent from the alloys used in missile technology. He collaborated with Dr. Somaraju and the two scientists developed the Kalam Raju stent, a low-priced, safe and effective device that has been used successfully to help many patients. Okay, technology has helped us to make unbelievable strides in the field of medicine, information, travel, research and education. And I think Dr. Kalam was right in placing so much of faith in technology. So this answer is all about technology. What all he has done. Okay, to whom he has done. Okay, why has he done. All right. So this is about technology. So it's easy for you to remember. Okay. Students should be provided with wings to fly. Who should give students wings to fly? Teachers should give students wings to fly. Okay. What is the meaning of these words? These words mean that students should be given the means to dream, not only to dream, to imagine, to explore and shape their own destiny. Only dreaming will not do any good to you, but you will also have to follow your dreams. By what? How? How can you follow your dreams? By working towards it, to make your dream your goal, okay? To explore how can you achieve your goal and shape your destiny towards your goal, okay? The most important aspect of his personality was his simplicity. What do you think this statement means? This statement means that Dr. Kalam's character is a simple nature which was completely devoid of any kind of pride. Okay, he was a very simple man. He did not have even a single percent, a little bit of pride in him. Okay, it means that. Why do you think such a characteristic is important or useful? Such a characteristic is important as well as useful because it helps you to keep learning and acquire knowledge and not just praising yourself in front of others or putting the others down. Okay, because it helps you to keep learning and acquire knowledge. Give an example from the text where he provided a simple solution to a problem. You will talk about the Kalam Raju stent. Okay. Dr. Kalam collaborated with Dr. Soma Raju and two scientists. They developed the Kalam Raju stent, a low-priced, safe and effective device, which could be used in place of the expensive coronary artery costing over 60,000 rupees. Okay? So, please make sure you all learn this lesson thoroughly. Okay? And tomorrow we will revise with either grammar or another something else. Okay, make sure you learn this Abdul Kalam's lesson, People's President and Courage lesson thoroughly. Okay, thank you.